Good afternoon, everyone. I would like to welcome you to the Chetwynd Secondary School Leaving Ceremony. We respectfully acknowledge the history, spirituality, and culture of the First Nations peoples with whom Treaty No. 8 was signed, and the territory wherein our school resides. As we begin this afternoon, we ask you to please turn off your cell phones at this point. As we introduce the members of the class of 2020, please feel free to take photographs as each graduate makes their way to the stage. At this point, I would like to ask Mrs. Henry to join me at the podium and be our MC for the afternoon.
Robert Paquette. Brendan Kane. Tyler Haroff. Keegan Smith. Michael Deck. Dylan Ethier. Nicole Eddy. Baby, you're a thug. You are. Come on, show 'em. You are. Make 'em go. Alexa Odette. Brooke Harmasek. Joshua Winland. Dean Thibault. Melissa Majoras. Ladies and gentlemen, the class of 2020. I would like to ask Mr. Mole to lead us in the singing of our national anthem. Will you all please stand?
Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all our sons command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true north strong and free. From far and wide, oh Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. Oh Canada, we stand on guard for thee. Oh Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
Thank you, Mr. Mold. Please be seated. Good day, ladies, gentlemen, family, and friends. We're here to honor these young men and women as they move into a new and exciting stage of their lives. We are pleased and privileged to have messages from several special guests, some of which will only be on your USB. I'd like to share with you a speech from Mrs. Candy Cluche on behalf of the school district. On behalf of the board office staff, I want to congratulate you all on your perseverance and dedication in becoming graduates at one of the most difficult times in our history. By making it this far, you have what you need to make a difference in the world and to be excited about a future that you will have a hand in making. I hope that you have had the opportunity to explore your passions and interests in your 13 years of education in School District 59. And while you may not know exactly what you want to do, I know that you have the skills and confidence to take yourself on a path towards fulfillment and happiness. Take care of yourself, be kind to those around you, and know that a great adult life awaits you.
Good afternoon, or good evening. On behalf of the Board of Education for School District 59, Peace River South, thank you for inviting us to be here with you today. We hope that your educational experience from School District 59 has filled you with a sense of pride, and this year, more than ever, we applaud the determination that has led to this accomplishment. You are the first graduating class to navigate multiple changes to education all within that final stretch to grad. And we can assure you that the dedication that you have shown these past few months will serve you well in the future. Although these last few months have been historic, it has been your hard work throughout your whole educational journey that has led to today's success. While our ceremonies look quite different this year, please know that your family, friends, and community are all gathering with a great sense of joy and pride as you cross the stage today.
As you enter the next chapter of your lives, you'll be entering a world undergoing rapid change, economically, politically, socially, and culturally. Graduates know that you have a voice that is being heard on a global scale. As many around the world are seeking equity, acceptance of diversity and inclusion, don't be caught standing still. Be your own champion and stand up to enact positive change. You, the graduating class of 2020, have the most opportunity of any other generation prior to you in almost every measurable aspect. Be the change you wish to see, and don't be afraid to take risks to achieve what you've only dreamt about. The future is in your hands, so be proud of where you are today, but always continue to push forward. Thank you for being part of School District 59, Peace River South, with your own individual personalities that brought laughter, tolerance, joy, integrity, trust, and determination.
School is a place where opportunities to try new things and to develop new talents are offered, with the hope that as you move through life, you find those things that challenge and excite you. These moments help you grow and find that unique you. As school trustees, our hope for you all is that you continue to grow and make choices that challenge you. We are confident that all you have learned will guide you through difficult times, and that your strengths will move you to where it is that you want to be.
As you move forward in your life, understanding that while your school years are soon behind you, the rest of your future lies in front of you. You've been part of your school community and part of our communities in a bigger way. As your teachers, parents, and guardians have taught you, your generation has trailblazed topics like inclusion and diversity, creating a deep sense of belonging. While you prove to the world, your generation will be the next community leaders, our world is shifting, and you can take great pride in being a large influence. Continue to trailblaze and push boundaries, keep asking questions, and never lose your curiosity. We are proud of your strength and your courage.
School District 59's values speak to fostering learning, modeling teamwork, and showing respect and integrity. You, the class of 2020, have worked hard this year, demonstrating the moral courage needed to make it through this pandemic and to provide an unparalleled model of leadership for the next class of graduates. As a parent of a graduating student, I am overjoyed to know that each of you are crossing this stage today. And while we all wish we could be together, celebrating hand in hand, we want to recognize the resilience and tenacity of the 2020 graduating class in stepping up to receive your diplomas in such a different way. We are so proud of the work that each of you have accomplished.
We, the Board of Education, have been inspired by your determination to express yourselves as individuals and applaud the many unique perspectives and values that you hold true. Now more than ever, the world needs leaders who embrace all diversity, and I am proud to say that I have no doubt you will continue to change the world by openly showing a loving acceptance of all. Stay true to you. Congratulations on this very important milestone, the first of many more to come.
So now it's your turn to write the history of your lives. As Winston Churchill said, history will be kind to me, for I intend to write it. Or you could think of it this way: make sure that you take enough risks in life that there will be some interesting stories for your grandkids, but live safely enough that you will be around to tell them the stories yourself. Congratulations to the class of 2020.
Next, I would like to welcome class representatives Olivia Beamish and Joshua Winland with an address to their class.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Firstly, I would like to express my gratitude to all the teachers that have got me to this point in my life. Without them, I would not be standing here. Today marks a milestone which did not get handed to us. At one time or another, we felt like we could not keep going. But with the support of our parents, friends, and teachers, we have overcome the first step into adulthood. To all the parents, we thank you for putting up with us for 18 years. You have given us a huge chunk of who we are as a person. You've taught us to respect other people and be forgiving. And the love that you show us is the love that we show other people. Thank you for allowing to grow up into the unique individuals you see here today.
I will never forget my first day of high school, the very start of the day where you awkwardly stand outside the doors, trying to seek out your friends, also super happy to be there. Then, as soon as the doors open, you have to be the first one in or else you're the rotten egg. After you get inside and settle in your classes, you blink. Next thing you know, you're in grade 11 getting ready for the year to end to start grade 12.
As everyone moves on in the next chapter of their life, I will forever remember all the wonderful memories I had at this high school. For example, breaking my arm going up the weight room stairs. First joining MeToWe and having the time of my life. Being able to go to Timmy's for lunch and barely making it back in time for the bell. Waiting to start art class. That building was a second home for me. And the best one yet, witnessing Moose getting dabbed in the neck by a grade 8 and almost peeing myself laughing.
This graduation has already shown us how capable we are of accomplishing our goals. I hope all of us here today can take this personal accomplishment as an example of how anything is possible when you put your minds to it. As we continue on in our lives, let us face each new problem with confidence, knowing that we have reached great highs and are equipped with the necessary tools to tackle our future.
Also, a huge thank you to Ms. Singer, Ms. Mounsey, Mr. Mason, Ms. Henry, and Ms. Rivard. You have played a personal part in each of our lives. Thank you so much for helping us with these difficult times. We will forever be in your debt.
Thank you, Olivia and Joshua. The valedictorian is the top academic student of the graduating class. This year, the distinction belongs to two students who represent academic excellence at Chetwynd Secondary School. Please welcome Dylan Ethier and Nicole Eddy for their valedictorian address.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, friends and family, teachers and faculty, but most importantly my classmates. I'd like to welcome you all to Chetwynd Secondary graduation of 2020. As I stand before you today, I wonder how I made it here. I'm remembering all of the times I said, I'll just do it later, I guess I'll have to wing it, and at least we're in this together. As I remember all of the times I thought these things to myself, I'm also reminded of the encouraging words that others filled my head with. I want to take a minute to thank those people for keeping me afloat these past 5 years. My mom and dad for always encouraging me to be the strongest, kindest, and best version of myself and absolutely nothing less. My brother, who taught me that hard work truly pays off and you can achieve what you put your mind to. To my teachers for putting up with my loud, mouthy comments and guiding me towards academic success through their own passion and drive. Moose, I think I speak for us all when I say that you never failed to make us feel welcome here at Chetwynd Secondary. It's everything from knowing all the hot gossip before we do to grabbing us by the back of the neck and ushering us back to our classroom from the hallway. If you're anything like myself, you've been looking forward to your high school graduation forever. Since 2020 sucks so much, this isn't necessarily the way we thought this day would go for us. Although we're not receiving a traditional graduation ceremony, I don't think we should let that affect how we feel about this milestone in our lives. Sure, we missed out on some things. Yeah, it blows. But I don't think we should allow the past 3 months to erase 5 years. We started here as kids, and we're still kids, but we did it. Most of us probably think of graduation as some sort of big ending. Personally, I'd rather think of it as more of a starting point. For the first time in our lives, we get to choose what's next for us. As each of us leaves this ceremony today, we're all beginning a new adventure. For some people, it might mean university or college. To some, it might mean working and saving money. And some of us might not know what we're doing in the fall, and that's okay. We're celebrating the past 5 years, but we're also celebrating what comes next. We're all about to set off in different directions, new cities, and new lives. But I think what's best about that is that we all get to embark on this new stage in our lives together. Other than learning that mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell, high school taught me some pretty big lessons. I learned one thing that stuck out more than the rest. You can't ever let someone else's opinion alter how you feel about yourself. I learned this one pretty quick. High school's a tough place to try and figure yourself out, and we all had to do it. It becomes too easy to seep into the trends and change who you are in order to fit in. I'm lucky that I had such a strong role model to teach me this lesson, my sister. She constantly inspires me to be the truest version of myself, no matter what others may say or think. I hope that in all of our future endeavors, we do not allow ourselves to change in order to please someone else. Now that it's all coming to an end, I want more time. I wish I had one more chance to run to Tim Hortons for iced coffee and hope I don't get yelled at when I'm late. I would have said goodbye and thank you to all my teachers who have shaped me into who I am today. I wish I had one more chance to say good luck to all my classmates. I'm incredibly excited to see where this next step takes us all, and I wish you all the best in this exciting new chapter of our lives. Believe it or not, we did it. Congratulations.
Good afternoon, friends and family, teachers, and most of all, graduates of the class of 2020. I will begin by thanking my friends and family who have supported me over the years. My mom and dad for teaching me how important it is to work hard at whatever I do. My teachers and school administrators who have motivated me with their enthusiasm. The counselors who have helped me find scholarships and plan for my future. The custodians who have kept our school looking pretty great, even if it does have a few years under its belt. And to Moose, who was always grabbing me by the ear and directing me to my appropriate class. This year has been absolutely crazy. And from this excitement in September of knowing that graduation was right around the corner, to realizing that it probably wasn't going to be quite what we were envisioning. But that doesn't change the fact that no matter what has happened, we're still a group of amazing individuals who have worked really hard to get here. And we have lots of great adventures ahead of us. 13 years of school is a long time. It's a lot of subjects and a huge amount of learning. What have we discovered? What have we taken away? When I was in my grade 11 English class, we had just started a unit on poetry. And I'm not one to take much interest in poetry, but one of the poems I read was quite captivating. It was called Mother to Son. It spoke about life being just like a staircase, filled with tacks and splinters, and it can be a dangerous climb. It's true that every life will have setbacks, and there will be times when giving up feels like the only option. But keep on moving and keep on climbing. Okay, well, yes, I know, Mom, I know. I put in an English reference and not a math one. So this quote is for you. Math may not teach us how to add love or to subtract hate, but it gives us hope that every problem has a solution. With some of the tough times that we are going through right now with the coronavirus and nationwide protests, hopefully we'll come out ahead as stronger people. I'm also very excited to be graduating as a dual Dogwood student. French immersion has been difficult at times, and sometimes I wanted to curse my parents for putting me into the program. But today I see why they did, and I can appreciate all the amazing benefits of speaking an extra language. Merci Alexa, c'était plaisant d'avoir quelqu'un sur mon côté tout au long du programme. I'm also grateful to the individuals who worked hard to keep the French program alive. Merci beaucoup, Mr. Vard, for going above and beyond as a French teacher and making this possible. Thank you to my coaches and my teammates. You are all so incredible. Sports are an important aspect of my life because when I step onto that court, I'm doing what I love. I'm going to miss the bus trips, the excitement of tournaments, and the adrenaline rush of close games, even if I am the one that screws it up. Sports have provided me with smiles and laughter and motivated me to go after the things I love. I'm sure each of us has something that drives us, and being able to share that with friends is something pretty special. I'm excited to see what life brings us as we head off in different directions. We will all face many challenges, so make sure you have good friends nearby to help take out the splinters along the way. Always hold your head high, control what you can control, and strive to do what you love. And guys, whether we're gonna admit it or not, we're gonna be known as the Chetwynd Secondary COVID Class of 2020. And while I'm up here, I just wanted to say on behalf of the graduating class, I would like to say a big thank you to Chet TV for recording our ceremonies today. They'll be creating a video of the day for each grad to take home, all at no charge. So thank you so much for your generosity. Elite Signs, they created the signs along the main road that were made at no cost to us. And Chetwynd Performance paid for the full cost of materials, while Peace Valley Industries fabricated and donated the metal stakes for the signs. And I think it's absolutely amazing to see our community coming together and helping us celebrate such an important milestone in our lives. So I think they deserve a big round of applause.
Thank you, Nicole and Dylan. I would like to now invite our guest speaker that the class chose, and that is Ms. Rivard. Can you come, please?
Oh, the Places You'll Go, by Dr. Seuss, adapted by Ms. Rivard and Ms. Portman. Oh, the places you can't go. Congratulations. Today is your day. You're off to great places when Dr. Henry says it's okay. You have brains in your head. You have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself any direction you choose. Just make sure you stay 2 meters apart, and eventually, they say, things will restart. You'll look up and down streets, look them over with care. About some you will say, I don't choose to go there. With your head full of brains and a mask on your face, you're too smart to go into any unsanitized place. And in that case, of course, you'll head straight out of there. Just make sure you wash your hands with care. Oh, the places you'll go eventually. Okay, now for the rest of my speech. There is a quote by Salvador Dali that says, "Do not fear perfection, for you will never reach it." I think it's accurate for you as you embark on this journey. Don't worry about following what other people might think is the perfect path, as there is no such thing. The rest of your life is wide open, and the options are endless. On your journey, you might hit some bumps in the road, you might backtrack a little, you might get it to a fork in the road, choose one path, and then come back and try the other one. You may even do a full U-turn and try again. All those options are okay. You need to do what's right for you, and as long as you keep trucking along, everything will work out. You don't know where you'll end up, but stay positive, take chances, and it will be worth it. Remember, it takes all kinds to succeed. Diversity is key. There are over a million different species of animals in the world, and they are all successful in their own way. From the unassuming sponge who filters gallons of water for food, to the arthropods with their jointed legs, and even the flatworms with their double daggers. They found what made them special, and they went with it. You should do the same. Find what makes you happy, which in itself means you're successful, and fight for it. Family and friends, at this time, the grads need roots and wings. Roots to keep them grounded, keep them safe, and to know you'll be there for them no matter what. But they also need wings. Wings to soar, wings to achieve, and wings to know they can do anything they set their mind to. I hope CSS has helped to provide you with roots and wings, so you are prepared for this next step. I have loved getting to know all of you, and you've helped me learn and grow as a teacher. I didn't cry before. As a teacher, coach, and person. I look forward to the visits and updates in the following years. Congrats, you did it, COVID style. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Rivard. This section of our program recognizes those individuals who have displayed outstanding performance in specific subject areas and have contributed significantly to student life at Chetwynd Secondary School during this 2019-2020 year. I will now ask Mr. Mole to present the English 12 Award.
So I'm presenting the English 12 Award, and ironically, I don't have a very long, eloquent speech. This person who's receiving the award is a fantastic writer, writes at a university level already in grade 12, and was an absolute pleasure to have them in class. And that person is Nicole Eddy.
Thank you, Mr. Mold. I will now ask Ms. Rivard to present the French Immersion Award. And just use that mic. Yeah.
I've been so lucky to teach both of these recipients for their entire French Immersion career. Je suis très fière de vous donner le prix. Bonne chance l'année prochaine, Dylan et Alexa.
Thank you, Ms. Rivard. I would now ask Ms. Portman to present the History 12 Award.
Law 12, law. Sorry.
Okay, it's law 12.
The Law 12 Award is given to the student with the highest academic achievement. I'd like to take some credit for this, but the recipient of this award has what cannot be taught. An intrinsic drive to learn, perform, and elevate himself. I'm honored to present the Law 12 gavel to Dylan Ethier.
Thank you, Ms. Portman. I am pleased to ask Ms. Norris to present Math Award, please.
Thank you.
The Workplace Math 11 Award is going to a student who came into the course with an attitude of he was going to get this award, and I'm pleased to say that he did achieve that. This award is going to Josh Winland.
Thank you, Ms. Norris. I would like to ask Ms. Callback to present the award for Senior Fine Arts.
Sorry, I get really nervous to start with. Senior Art Award goes to a student who's shown exemplary art skills, whether it's from grade 8 through to grade 12 or just in their final year. The recipient this year has not only grown as an artist, but also as an individual since I started teaching them in grade 6. Over the last year, few years, you know, when he started, he wasn't the best artist. He liked to get it done and had fun with it, which was the main part in elementary school. But he took it seriously the last 3 years. In fact, in grade 10, he walked into my class and informed me, I'm going to get this award, Ms. Callback. This is my plan, I'm gonna get it. And I looked at him and I said, you got a lot of competition. Because I can honestly say this grade 12 class has an exceptional amount of wonderful artists. It is with great pleasure and pride that I give it to Josh Winland.
Thank you, Ms. Callback. At this time, I would like to call upon Ms. Curran and Ms. Rivard to present the Anatomy, Physiology, Chemistry, Physics, and Warner Wilson's Awards. You've got a whole group of them here, so I'm not sure how you want to do this. You need a paper? Don't need it. Okay.
I'm really happy to give this award to the birthday girl. It's for Anatomy and Physiology 12, Alexa Odette.
Thank you, Ms. Rivard. Ms. Curran?
Hi, congratulations, everyone. I'm here today to celebrate with you, but also to present the Warner Wilson Academic Sciences Award, along with the Chemistry 12 and Physics 12 Award. So Moose told me that we needed to be brief, so I thought we'll just give it to the same person, I guess. Nicole Eddy. And of course, I'm joking. Nicole's incredibly talented academically, but also just a genuine person. She's hardworking, she has the work ethic and the dedication, but she has that people skills and personality that I'm absolutely convinced that she'll be successful in the health sciences field that she's chosen. So congratulations, Nicole.
You're gonna need a second arm. Oh. Yeah, stop being so good. Okay, we're gonna lay that down so it doesn't fall.
Yeah.
You're gonna be a scientist.
You should.
We are now.
Did you need a? I've never gotten so many awards in my life.
Your mom's
so
okay, so that's good. Thank you, Ms. Rivard and Ms. Caron. Ms. Caron, you can stay up here. I would now like to ask Ms. Caron to present the Senior Foods Award.
Wow, I was listening to the previous presenters talk about this student and they stole my words for a lot of different reasons, not the least of which a little bit of a Winland dynasty. Joshua, before, like he was in grade 8 and he came to me and said, I'm going to be in your foods class. I'm so excited. I'm going to win this award. When I went away from my mat leave, he said, I'm not taking foods while you're gone. I'm going to wait till you get back. And that's just who he is. Clearly, when he has a goal, nothing is going to stop this guy. Wow. I think he's creative. He puts himself into everything, and he's fun. And that's what makes a really good chef. And chefs and artists are the same one and the same, so it does not surprise me that he's taken these other awards. I just wanted to show you what we had made for Josh, though, as well, for his senior foods apron. Come on down, Josh.
Thank you, Ms. Caron. I would now like to ask Ms. Rivard to come to present the Senior Female Athlete of the Year Award.
Okay, these ones always make me cry, so I'm just gonna be very brief. I've watched this player play since grade 8, and she, okay, it goes to Brooke Harmasek.
Thank you, Ms. Rivard. I would like to ask Ms. Ethier to present the award for the Senior Athlete of the Year.
This award is being shared by two very, very deserving young men. They took part in both volleyball and basketball. And they have all the attributes that you would expect. They work hard every single practice, every single game. They want to improve, and so they take the feedback of their coaches and they work even harder. They encourage their teammates, and they always do what's best for their team. Whether that's cheering from the sidelines, day in and day out, as they recover from an injury, or agreeing to play a position even though it's not in their first pick, but it's what the team needs. And they are already choosing to give back to the sports that they love by coaching. The top male senior athletes go to Michael Deck and Dylan Ethier.
Thank you, Ms. Ethier. I will now ask Mr. Mason to help me present the awards for Top Applied Arts and Science and Top Academic Arts and Science. First of all, we are going to go with Top Applied Arts and Science. This award is based on the average of the top 28 credits and given to a student who is taking courses in the fine arts and applied skills areas, either in English, or sometimes they might be taking a A&W math instead of a pre-calculus math as well. This year, the award goes to a student who has been extremely successful in the area of applied skills, most specifically in his art and food courses, and I'm pleased to present this award to Josh Winland.
Oh my gosh.
excuse now.
Thank you. I'd like to invite Mr. Mason.
I have the pleasure of announcing the recipients of the award for the top academic arts and science. To be eligible for this award, it is based on the average of the top 28 credits, including English 12 and at least three other academic subjects. One more grade 12 course after that, and then two more at either the grade 11 or 12 courses. I'm pleased to present this award to two students who have met and exceeded all that criteria listed above, Nicole Eddy and Dylan Ethier.
Okay, this is Dill's. Yep, and this is yours. That's for hanging.
It's for hanging, yes.
Congratulations, Dylan and Nicole. I also have the pleasure of announcing the final award of the afternoon, and that is the Principal's Award. The Principal's Award recognizes an individual who takes on a leadership role within the school. Over the years, two students have excelled in their leadership across the school level. When I asked the staff for names, two names routinely arrived at my email address. They have been involved in athletics, extracurriculars, clubs, and the like. I would like to call Dylan Ethier and Josh Winland to the front, please. Congratulations, gentlemen. Next, we're going to move into the scholarship and bursaries. And as we do so, I would like to acknowledge the tremendous support from our community and outside contributors to the granting of scholarships and bursaries to the students of Chetwynd Secondary School. I would like to thank Ms. Dixie for the tremendous amount of time and energy she puts into making sure students apply for scholarships and bursaries, and the contributors are involved in the process as well. I would also like to thank the members of the awards committee for their role in this process. Students, when Ms. Dixie calls your name, remember this is the time to stand and accept your acceptance and acknowledgement. Ms. Dixie, if you would come forward.
Good afternoon. We are so fortunate to live in such a generous community that provides CSS students with over $38,000 in bursaries and scholarships. The 2020 grad class recipients are as follows: Aboriginal Educational Advisory Council, Robert Paquette. Canadian Parents for French, Dylan Ethier and Alexa Odette. Catholic Women's League, Dylan Ethier. Chetwynd Community Arts Council, Josh Winland. Chetwynd CUPE Local 3052, Nicole Eddy. Chetwynd District Minor Hockey, Alexa Odette and Brendan Kane. Chetwynd Electric Eels, Nicole Eddy. Chetwynd Forest Industries, Nicole Eddy, Dylan Ethier, Brooke Harmasek, Alexa Odette. Josh Winland. Chetwynd Masonic Lodge, Michael Deck.
CSS Pack, Nicole Eddy, Brooke Harmiset, Alexa Odette. Chetwynd Teachers Association, Dylan Ethier, Josh Winland. Chetwynd Volunteer Fire Department, Michael Deck. District of Chetwynd, Brooke Harmisack. Don Titus Pack, Dylan Ethier. Does Cho Construction, Brendan Kane, Josh Winland. Elks, Josh Winland. The Kang Athletic Citizenship Award, Dylan Ethier. Little Prairie Elementary School, Michael Deck. Little Prairie Pack, Nicole Eddy. Ministry Scholarship, Dylan Ethier, Alexa Odette, Josh Winland. Peace River Regional District, Nicole Eddy. Royal Canadian Legion, Brendan Kane. Shell Canada, Nicole Eddy. Standard Bus, Nicole Eddy. Unifor, Dylan Ethier, Alexa Odette, Nicole Eddy. Chetwynd Secondary School Motivated Athlete, Brooke Harmisack. Paul Beck Memorial, Michael Deck. Christina Haggard Memorial for Arts, Josh Winland. Christina Haggard Memorial for Trades, Michael Deck. Christina Haggard Memorial for Sports, Brooke Harmisack. And the United Steels Workers Union, Dylan Ethier. It's a sincere pleasure to wish you all good luck in your future endeavors. I know you're going to be amazing. Congratulations.
Thank you, Ms. Dixie. Before we move on to the slideshow, I would like to take a moment to recognize a few people on the stage who you might have determined already are not just graduating with the regular dogwood, but also a dual dogwood. And I would like Dylan Ethier and Alexa Odette to please stand. These two students are completing a French immersion program, which requires an inordinate amount of flexibility on their part in order to find courses that meet the requirements in order to attain that dual dogwood, along with extra coursework beyond what other graduates might have on the stage. Congratulations, that's quite an achievement. I would also like to acknowledge Michael Deck, if you would stand. Michael has completed his first year of the electrical program through Northern Lights College as part of his dual dogwood program. Congratulations. Now, ladies and gentlemen, if you could bring your attention to the wall over there, the grad class has created a slideshow they would like to share with you. Thank you. So just before I begin my closing remarks for the afternoon, a few housekeeping items. In a few moments, the grads will be done and they will be exiting the stage. When they do so, they are going to come back to you in your spot, where you are as a family, for an opportunity in a few minutes to have a first dance with their family. Grads, if you are a recipient of a scholarship or bursary, before you leave today, there will be a package awaiting you back here on the table with all the pertinent information about the claiming of that scholarship and bursary, along with thank you letters to the local businesses and donors. I told you I'd keep my closing remarks brief, and I will. To you, the graduating class of 2020, I want you to know you have been one of the most focused and organized grad classes that I can recall in all of my time at CSS. I would like to thank all of the grads and their parents who worked so hard over the year to make the vision you had for grad attainable. I would like to acknowledge the work of the young women and men who spent hours in here recently to make this space look the way it does. Your efforts did not go unnoticed. Also, thank you to the staff who stepped in to help decorate, Mrs. Mounsey, Ms. Henry, Mr. Mould, to Mrs. Singer and Mrs. Newells for all the support you provide over the year, and Ms. Rivard for all the time and effort you put into being our grad coordinator. It's much appreciated. I think it's safe to say no one in this room could have envisioned or predicted how these last 3 months would have turned out, which unfortunately has led to the vision you had for grad not being fully attained. As upsetting as that might be to all of us here today, and to those who wanted to be here to celebrate with you but are unable to due to the restrictions we're under, we've all learned an important life lesson. As organized and planned as you might be, there can always be an unforeseen obstacle that gets in your way. You as a grad class could have thrown your hands up in the air and given up. You did not. Instead, what you did was adapt to what was given to you, focus on your future, balance your work and school responsibilities, support each other and the adults in your life through this tough time, and most impressively, persevere to reach this significant milestone in your life. After speaking with a number of you, I know that some of you have uncertainty about what the next phase of life might look like now. Plans are changing, and perhaps new opportunities will arise. If that makes you nervous, remember, it's okay, because I know you have the resiliency, grit, and strength to handle anything that's thrown at you. Sitting up there today proves that. You didn't let a global pandemic stop you from graduating. You've proven that you can do anything you want if you work hard and stay positive. On a personal note, I will miss all the conversation that we've had, both the good things in your life and the not so great. I will also miss the random parkour moments in the parking lot, chasing you to class, which I think has been mentioned a few times today, and most importantly, watching you continue to grow into what I know will be amazing adults. It's been a pleasure getting to spend the last 5 years with you. Please know that I believe in each one of you and that we are proud to call you graduates. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor at this time to present to you the Chetwynd Secondary School Class of 2020.
Wish for you that this life becomes That this life becomes all.